Is it possible that a certain Neanderthal gene protects against the severity of COVID-19? This gene could be responsible for the people who have it within their DNA to only experience mild symptoms or no symptoms at all, while the people who don't have this gene suffers severe symptoms that could be life-threatening. My name is Kaylee, and today's video will focus on this one question. Could a certain Neanderthal gene protect against the severity of COVID-19, and how did the researchers find this out? I understand that after nearly 2 years, we're all a bit COVID tired. It's everywhere in our lives, on the TV, in the newspapers, and the internet is one of the places we can come to escape from it all. But today, that's not the case. I didn't plan to create a video about anything having to do with COVID, but now that I'm looking into the hominids and the Neanderthals' Denisovans, I feel like it is my duty to report on these discoveries. And this is incredibly valuable information that came out a few days ago, and I haven't seen anyone talk about it anywhere. So, here I am. Let's talk about the gene OAS1 that includes the protective variant RS10774671-G, and how this affects the development of the SARS-CoV-2 protein, the virus that causes the COVID-19 disease. There are many factors that can influence how our body responds to diseases, in addition to old age and underlying health complications and diseases. We now know that genetics can definitely have an impact as well. And now we have information about just how much certain genetics can influence the development of the SARS-CoV-19 protein, and how this affects the people who have this gene. First, let's take a look into how this was researched, but do understand that I'm glossing over some of the intricate information that you can find in the articles linked down below. I'm not a scientist, and I want to make the information as simple as possible so that everyone has the ability to understand what I'm talking about, instead of going into the intricate scientific details that just confuse everyone. Previous studies into the genetics affecting the development of COVID-19 infections found that people in Europe carrying a particular segment of DNA had a 20% lower risk of developing severe symptoms. This particular segment within their DNA is packed with numerous genetic variants, so even though you know the segment within the DNA, it is still a needle in a haystack at this point. But you want to figure out which particular variant it is so that you can create medical treatment against the severe COVID-19 infections. Researchers in this latest study therefore only looked at people with this particular segment in their DNA. And to do this, they went a bit of a different route than you might think. Instead of looking at the Europeans only, like the previous studies would suggest, they actually looked into people with African descent. Now I hear you think, why African descent? That's a good question, and the answer to that is simple. We know that Neanderthal inheritance occurred after the ancient migration out of Africa. Most of the people in Africa lack Neanderthal DNA, as I've mentioned before on the channel. They, therefore, lack the majority of the particular DNA segment that was found to contain the variant that is responsible for the minor symptoms. But there is a small overlap within this particular DNA region between both people from Europe and Africa, which makes the search for the needle in the haystack slightly easier because, you know, you make the haystack a little bit smaller. So the researchers found that people from predominantly African descent had the same protection as those of European descent, and this allowed them to pinpoint a specific gene variant. The gene variant known as RS10774671-G determines the length of the protein encoded by the Neanderthal gene OAS1. Previous studies have shown that the longer variant of the protein is much more effective at breaking down SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19. The analysis included 2,787 hospitalized COVID-19 patients of African descent and 130,997 people in a control group from 6 cohort studies. 80% of the people of African descent carried the protective variant within their DNA. The genetic risk factors and studies like these are key in developing new medications against COVID-19, both for people who are hospitalized with severe symptoms and for those who haven't been infected yet. It could lead to a new vaccine or medication to treat patients with severe symptoms that are possibly even life-threatening, and this way we could contain the virus better. Most studies so far have been done with mostly individuals of predominantly European descent, and this study shows us the importance of including people of different ancestries, because it will give us much more information and makes finding the needle in the haystack so much easier. Neanderthals have been playing a significant role to modern humans since the first modern humans encountered them, and their importance to us has never ceased to amaze me. Even in this pandemic, in modern times, they still play a key role in our lives, tens of thousands of years after they suddenly disappeared. As you've seen in this video, I'm only looking at the science, and I leave out any personal opinions about the pandemic or the virus or the measures taken, and I ask that you, the viewers, do the same. Let's keep this a nice place for scientific discussion in the sense of genes playing a role. Let's focus on the message and not on a disease. A gene that's been given to us through interbreeding by Neanderthals is now protecting us all against a disease, and it could help everyone on the planet eventually if we do more research to this. If you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified every time I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner or one of the links in the description down below, or click a video in the end card, whatever you do. I would also like to thank everyone who's been supporting me both on Patreon and my channel members. Your support means the absolute world to me. Thank you so much. Share the video, leave me a comment what you thought, and let's end this one here, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I did not want to talk about COVID on the channel, and I did. So if you came here for non-COVID stuff, then in the next video, I promise I won't mention it. I haven't mentioned it at all in the past 2 years now. Sorry. Also, 50,000 subscribers. I just reached it right before filming, and I'm absolutely gobsmacked. It's staggering. 50,000 people decided to subscribe to my channel for my work, and I'm absolutely blown away. So thank you so much, and I hope that I can keep making you guys proud. I hope.